Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 15th of July. Indian Prime Minister stresses on upskilling on World Youth Skills Day amid COVID crisis. Engineers hold protests in Pakistan-administered Kashmir, demand technical allowance. And Maldives reopened borders after almost 4 months of closure due to COVID-19. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday said the coronavirus pandemic has presented new challenge for the world, which everyone needs to be prepared for. Addressing the nation's youth on World Youth Skills Day, he said India has the potential to capitalize the skilling opportunities, which in turn can supplement the global demand.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed the nation's youth on World Youth Skills Day on Wednesday and said there is a need to learn and upgrade our skills during the times of coronavirus and adapt to the new needs. This day marks the 5th anniversary of the launch of Skill India Mission. He said that India has the potential to capitalize the skilling opportunities, which in turn can supplement the global demand. PM Modi also presented a new mantra for the youth, which will help them stay relevant in the time of crisis and empower them.
Corona ke is samay mein to ye sawal aur bhi ahem ho gaya hai. Saathiyo, main iska ek hi jawab deta hoon. Relevant rehne ka mantra hai skill, reskill or upskill.
Meanwhile, India's COVID-19 tally has reached 936,181 as 29,429 new coronavirus cases were reported in the last 24 hours. Out of the total cases, 319,840 are currently active. After a surge of infections, India's high-tech hub of Bengaluru went back into a coronavirus lockdown for a week on Tuesday, threatening to derail government efforts to revive a stuttering economy. While cases in the main cities of Mumbai and Delhi account for most of the tally, infections are picking up in smaller cities, forcing authorities to reimpose curbs.
Moving on, parts of India's northeastern Assam and eastern Bihar provinces continue to be severely affected by heavy monsoon rains and subsequent flooding. In Bihar, where some districts have submerged due to the ongoing rains resulting in flood, in Assam, the waters have resulted in the killing of at least 61 people. Most of the rivers in the region, including the Brahmaputra, are in spate as they are flowing above the danger level. Many roads, bridges and other infrastructure have been damaged in the floods and landslides across Assam. Not just human beings, but many wild animals in Kaziranga National Park, a World Heritage Site, too have been displaced and killed. According to Forest Department officials, over 90% of the park have been inundated and 66 wild animals, including 2 rhinos, have died. Scores of engineers carried out a peaceful rally in Pakistan-administered Kashmir to demand the technical allowance, which they say is being deliberately denied to them by the administration. The demonstrators issued an ultimatum saying that the intensity of their rallies would increase if the government didn't pay immediate heed to their demands.
A large number of engineers carried out a peaceful rally in Muzaffarabad town of Pakistan-administered Kashmir to demand a 1.5% technical allowance of their salaries as per the 2017 pay scale. The demonstrators claim the technical allowance is being deliberately denied to them by the administration. Issuing an ultimatum, the engineers warned the intensity of their rallies would increase if government did not pay an immediate heed to their demands.
जब हक देने की बात आती है बस किस्मती के साथ एक साजिश के तहत इंजीनियर्स को उनका हक नहीं दिया जाता। ये जो ठंडे कमरों में बैठे हुए लोग फैसला करते हैं उनको ये याद रखना चाहिए, ये जो बिल्डिंग है, ये स्ट्रक्चर है, ये जो रोड्स हैं, ये जो बिजली है, पानी है, सारा हमारी कार है, नुमाया है हमारे बुजुर्गों के, जो हमारे सीनियर थे उनकी कावशों का नतीजा है।
पाकिस्तान विच हैज गिवन सिमिलर अलाउंसेस टू इंजीनियर्स इन इट्स अदर प्रोविंसेस has turned a blind eye to the demands of these men in Muzaffarabad town of the illegally occupied region.
इस कबील से ताल्लुक रखने वाले लोगों को अगर अपनी लाजिक से और डिसेंसी से अपने मुतालबात उन्हें तस्लीम ना करें तो ये अफसोस का मकाम है। और इससे भी ज़्यादा अफसोसनाक बात यह है कि पॉलिटिकल एलीट जो है ना इस बात को मानती है, इसको तस्लीम करती है, लेकिन हमारी ब्यूरोक्रेसी जो है ना इसमें आड़े आती है।
It is not just about the engineers. Locals claim Pakistan has systematically denied benefits, rights and resources to the people of the illegally occupied territory for years. Demands and dissents have been suppressed using excessive force and in some cases even a legislative route has been used to keep them marginalized and deprived.
In news from Nepal, Nepal in damage control mode following controversial Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli's remarks over the birthplace of Hindu Lord Ram in India has said Oli did not intend to hurt the sentiments of anyone or any cultural values by his statement. Oli on Monday in his statement claimed that the real birthplace of Lord Ram lies in Nepal and not in India.
Nepal has issued a clarification over its Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli's controversial claim that Hindu Lord Ram was born in the Himalayan country and not in India. A statement from Nepal's Foreign Ministry on Tuesday evening said Oli's remark was not political and not meant to disrespect Ayodhya, believed to be Ram's birthplace located in northern India, and its significance. Oli's claim has been widely condemned both in Nepal and India. Deputy Chair of the ruling Nepal Communist Party or NCP, Bamre Gautam, criticizing Oli's dubious claim, said he had always been scared about time when Oli would come forward with such unproved information. Spokesperson for the ruling Nepal Communist Party or Narayan Kaji Shrestha also took on Twitter to sarcastically react on Oli's statement. Relations between New Delhi and Kathmandu have recently worsened due to a territorial claim pressed by Oli, which he got endorsed by the country's parliament through a constitutional amendment. India has rejected Nepal's claim as untenable and as without any historical evidence or basis.
Moving on to news from Afghanistan. The Pentagon announced on Tuesday that US troops have withdrawn from 5 military bases and reduced the size of its forces in Afghanistan as part of the agreement reached with Taliban in February.
The United States has withdrawn from 5 bases in Afghanistan and reduced the size of its forces there as part of the agreement it entered into with the Taliban earlier this year, the Pentagon announced on Tuesday. Chief Pentagon spokesman Jonathan Hoffman said in a statement, U.S. forces in Afghanistan remain in mid-8,000s and 5 bases formerly occupied by U.S. forces have been transferred to our Afghan partners. The U.S. and the Taliban signed a historic agreement on February 29 aimed at reducing violence in hopes of fostering bilateral talks between the Afghan government and the extremist group to end the war-torn nation's 18-year conflict. According to the deal, the U.S. had 135 days to fulfill its pledge to reduce troops to 8,600 from nearly 14,000 in Afghanistan, which ended Monday. The Taliban agreed not to allow Al-Qaeda, Islamic State or any other militant group to operate in areas they control as part of the pact.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa has called for an increase in the number of PCR tests to detect COVID cases as fears have emerged of another wave of community cases in the country after a gap of over 2 months.
Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa chaired a meeting of COVID task force to review the current situation in Colombo Tuesday evening. Gotabaya called for an increase in the number of PCR tests to detect COVID cases as fears have emerged of another wave of community cases in the country after a gap of over 2 months. He assured that the challenge of protecting the people until the COVID-19 pandemic is eradicated from the world will be met by controlling the risk of spread of the virus from time to time within the country. His comments came as over 500 fresh cases have been detected over last week from a rehabilitation center, and the chief epidemiologist of the health ministry has warned that there is a significant risk of community spread. There are 666 active COVID-19 cases currently among total infections of 2,665 so far, with 11 deaths. Parliamentary elections that was postponed earlier are scheduled for 5th of August, and the Election Commission is closely monitoring the situation following a recent spike in coronavirus cases.
Maldives reopened its borders for international travel on Wednesday, with health and safety protocols in place amid the COVID-19 outbreak. Maldives has so far reported a total of 2,217 COVID-19 confirmed cases.
Maldives on Wednesday opened its borders for international travel after months-long closure due to the outbreak of global COVID-19 pandemic. Earlier on Tuesday, President Ibrahim Mohamed Soli himself visited the international airport in Male to check on the measures in place to screen passengers, testing capacity and protocols in place to ensure social distancing and good hygiene. Maldives had closed its borders on March 27 to stop the spread of the coronavirus that resulted in impacting its largely tourism-dependent economy. According to President Soli, the Maldivian government is now planning on other activities to help the country recover and rebuild under a new normal after the COVID-19 halt. The island nation is also expected to witness further easing of temporary restrictive measures this month, like prayers in congregations, reopening of schools and dine-in service for restaurants and cafes. Maldives has so far reported a total of 2,217 COVID-19 cases, out of which 1,813 patients have recovered. An active number of the cases stands at only 394.
With the rising demand for durable, eco-friendly and locally made products, water bottles made out of bamboo in India's northeastern Tripura province are increasingly finding takers. Have a look.
Bamboo water bottles of India's eastern Tripura province, which are known for their durable, eco-friendly and stylish nature, are increasingly finding takers. The handcrafted bamboo covers wrapped around copper bottles involve no usage of chemicals. That has led to good response for products not only in India but also abroad. Bamboo is the fastest growing woody plant in the world. Some of the prime species of bamboo have recorded growth rate of 3 to 4 feet in a single day.
It was well accepted by not only the Indian, all corners of the country, even of course from all corners of the world, especially European countries, then Middle East countries, then USA and Australia. Is tarah ka country jahan pe ye wala eco-friendly products ke liye demand hai, wahan se bahut acha response aaya hai. Do din mein for, I cannot even believe, around 4,000 queries aaya hai do din mein.
Apart from bottles, bamboo poles and reeds are used for making several household items like furniture, baskets, mugs, wall hangings, chandeliers and intricate jewelry pieces.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.